mic's on. Good evening, I'm Dan Fretland. I'm one of the band directors here at Jefferson High School, and we want to welcome you, on behalf of the entire band program, to the annual winter concert. We're really excited about this one. As you can see, we are slated to have all four of the bands on stage together performing for the grand finale, so this is always a treat and a nice way to get ready to head into our winter break. But just want to welcome you here tonight, and you're moments away from hearing from our symphonic band, and we're going to get right to it. A few little short conversations along the way. We'd like to talk to you just briefly about some of the information that's in your program, but we'll separate that and leave that to some of the in-between bands' times. So we're going to get rolling right away here with the symphonic band, and here comes Mr. Levine.
Thank you. program notes from composer Randall Sandridge. Darkland's Legends paints portraits of three of the central characters that inhabit this fantastic land that exists in my imagination. Movement 1, Dance of the Mad Prince. Prince Loon is the many-faced prince of the Darklands. Just like the moon, his face is constantly changing, as does his personality. This dance movement alternates between a mischievous staccato statement juxtaposed with a bombastic and violent interjection as the prince's many personalities battle with each other, while small chromatic figures signify his mad laughter. In this movement, David meets the character who helped show him out of the dark forest. David eventually runs away from the mad prince, who he can hear laughing in the distance. Enjoy.
Shipwrecks. Others perhaps got free from or were abandoned by early settlers moving inward. These hardy souls have withstood storm and tempest, and in a few cases they have survived the incursion of modern man. In 1998, the horses on Shackelford Banks, an uninhabited island in the Outer Banks of North Carolina, were going to be moved elsewhere. However, many people gathered up enough support for the horses to stay and be protected. These Mustangs proudly remain and flourish to this day.
Thank you.
was commissioned to commemorate the 100th anniversary of the National Park Service. The composer, Jack Wilds, felt that the piece was easy to write in each of the parks, including conjures of vivid emotional reactions that lend themselves to portrayal in musical form. The first movement is a short fantasia based on the folk song Rock Mountain. It is meant to portray the sheer joy of emerging from foothills of the Rocky Mountains and getting one's first real view of the panorama of snow-capped peaks. The second movement attempts to communicate the first wonder that one feels when confronted by the sheer size of a redwood tree. The third movement is a dramatic portrayal of pictographs at Big Bend National Park in Wexington, Texas.
So fun to be able to perform again.
So with that, I think we will move on to Varsity Band. So lots more great music to come.
This monumental programmatic work captures the myth and legend of Zeus, the mythical master of the gods. The piece opens as Zeus becomes involved in the Trojan War, hurling lightning bolts at his opponents. The tension soon subsides as we are introduced to the lyrical theme of Hera, Zeus's wife. As the story unfolds, Zeus makes his domain in the mountaintops and the clouds, where he can survey all of creation. Tension builds as Zeus battles Typhon in hand-to-hand combat, ending ultimately with Zeus throwing Mount Etna at the monster. From here, the tension subsides, and the return of Hera's lyrical theme builds to an ending of incredible power and grandeur as Zeus reaffirms his stature as the ruler of Mount Olympus.
Thank you.
of Fire makes extensive use of the double harmonic scale, which we typically associate with the music of the Middle East. Ocean of Fire portrays the vast desert landscape in both its beauty and unrelenting hostility.
Thank you.
next piece you're going to hear from the Jefferson Wind Ensemble here is a Lord of the Rings symphony suite. The original piece by Johann de Meij was actually a five-movement piece that lasted a little bit over an hour. We are condensing, don't worry, we're condensing, we are condensing this piece down into about 8 minutes, and really we could use more time, but if you're familiar with the book, The Lord of the Rings, started out as one giant book and then was broken up into three bits, I assume because that one giant book was maybe too much for readers to digest in one sitting. But in any case, the music you're about to hear is from the late 80s rather than the movie soundtrack, which you might have seen in the program and thought, I wonder if this is the movie soundtrack. This is actually a suite that was written to depict some of the characters as well as some of the landscapes from the original tale. And I'm not going to wax on about the story of, the hobbits and Gandalf, and but would encourage you to check out the book and the series if you haven't done so yet. In any case, we are going to be creating a musical landscape here that creates a number of different characters through articulations, through dynamics, through tempos, and we've had a great time exploring this piece. We hope you enjoy The Lord of the Rings.
Thank you. Ghost Fleet is a nickname for the James River Reserve Fleet, a group of several dozen decommissioned warships anchored in the James River. The music represents the spirit of these ships as the ghostly fleet breaks free, returning to the high seas and the former days of glory. A beautiful lyrical melody is woven throughout the piece, which interjects the former battles and the ending of the final return to port.
Okay, well, we have one more tune before just a short break. Looking at the program, I think it speaks for itself, so we're just going to go for it, and just know that when we are done with Sleigh Ride, we will bring the lights up. You're free to move about the cabin, and we will get back to the combined bands pieces shortly. Thanks so much. Introduce our Jefferson Band Booster Club president, Cindy Ratliff, who's got just a couple minutes for you. I will follow that by introducing our Jefferson Band seniors, and then we're going to have at it.
Good evening. As Dan mentioned, my name is Cindy Ratliff. I am the current president of the Jefferson Band Booster Club. We are the parent-run organization that supports the band program here at Jefferson. We normally hold our meetings on the second Tuesday of the month, but since that is tonight, we have no December meeting. We will resume our meetings on January 11th, 6:30 p.m. in the band room, so I invite you to come to our meetings. We will be making our final preparations on that date for our largest fundraiser of the year, which is our 6th annual Band Cake Breakfast. And the main reason that I'm here tonight to talk to you is to promote our Band Cake Breakfast. It is a very fun event. We have Chris Cakes of Iowa that comes up with a giant griddle. They flip pancakes in the air. We serve pancakes, sausage, coffee, and juice. And I believe we are going to have student entertainment once again this year, so that should be great. This is our largest fundraiser, and it requires a lot of volunteers. So I hope that you will go to our website, which is jeffersonbandboosterclub.com. You can click on the volunteer link, and it will take you to the site that you can sign up to volunteer that day. And if you cannot volunteer your time, we also need donations of things such as orange juice and creamer. So you can find those on that link. Ticket information will be sent home with your students just after winter break. And until that time, we hope you spread the word to your family and friends about this event so that we can have a great turnout and make lots of money for our band program here. And I think that's all I had to say. Thank you for coming out tonight and supporting the band here at Jefferson, and enjoy the rest of the program.
Thank you, Cindy. Well, as we come to the end of our program here, I just want to take a second and introduce you to our 21-22 Jefferson Band seniors. They have been with us through thick and thin, and they are the heartbeat of our program, and we are going to ask them all to stand as their names are called individually. If you could just hold all applause until the end. Seniors were offered the opportunity to dress up, if they so chose, in winter-themed apparel, and some of them have chosen to do that. So if you'd hold your applause, feel free to include giggles as you see fit. And so here we go, our 21-22 Jefferson Band seniors. We have, and I'll ask them to stand, Andrew Barton, Kelsey Bechtold, Lily Benson, Nathan Brokering, Will Cornelis, Cullen Dunphy, Trevor Eckert, Gail Item, Jasper Gabrielson, Eric Henson, Alex Hess, Maya Hidalgo, Mason Hobbs, Zach Jensen, Lexi Johnson, Trevor Johnson, Jeffrey Q, Gus Linden, Fiona Lynch, Anna Mattson, Kayla McMayer, Jamie Melville, Zach Miller, Katie Murnan, Kian Oldre, Logan Oscarson, Ricardo Price, Ruth Sandberg, Riley Spencer, Zach Studdiford, Noah Swanson, Hannah Van Overbeck, and Megan Zhang. How about a round of applause for our 21-22 band seniors? Okay, and the point we've all been waiting for, the entire Jefferson Band program on stage. How about that? And Noah Spencer. Interesting segue, but we're back to it now. And now the part you are the part we've all been waiting for. Okay, moving on. We'll finish up with the program here. We, as many of you know, with that email that said, "Hey, we have a quick after school rehearsal today." Of course, we've been rehearsing these next two tunes in class, but separately, right? And so today after school was the first time we got a chance to put this together. And I think you will be pleasantly pleased with the results, as we certainly are. So here to conduct Jingle Bells and get this final portion underway is Mr. Levine, and I'm going to give him the baton. Thanks and enjoy.
things up tonight, on behalf of Mr. Fretland and myself, once again, we just want to say how proud we are of these amazing student musicians up here. How about another round of applause for these performers?